Deca is probably going to fall into like it because Primo and Master, and they're relatively similar to each other. Deca would probably be my next one in line if we're talking about injectables, 100%. It does have that effect. I mean, it's fast. People think Deca is like slow acting. Yeah, on paper it's slow acting. You can get joint relief like within a week to 2 weeks of your first shot. It's it's relatively noticeable. You don't have to take NPP to get that noticeable like boost in your joints and stuff like that. In fact, I utilized Deca at 100 milligram per week, which is plenty for me. I was on 200 milligrams a test, and I even told my doctor I was going to do it. This is post shoulder surgery, labrum surgery. It was BPC 157, TB 500. Actually, did I run? I may have not run TB 500. I was running the BPC 157 to stay off of like Advil and stuff like that. And then I added in 100 milligrams of Deca, and I was doing I think like 2 IUs of growth hormone. And no, I was dumbbell pressing 90-pound dumbbells a month after my surgery, and I like the joint pain basically went away. And when I came off the Deca, guess what? I noticed some inflammation coming back in the joint, and it kind of sucks. But I'm like, I'm not going to stay on Deca year round. Like, there's no way.
Well, that's what people, a lot of people don't understand about Deca is Deca is not like magically going in there and healing your joint. You know, it's not like the negative part about Deca is that, especially for, you know, like me and you work out in the gym, is I get in there and I'm like, oh yeah, my shoulders are feeling good today. You know, I'm jumping up, I'm hitting PRs today. And then, you know, you don't realize, but you're actually doing some damage to your shoulder. It's just masking the pain because it, you know, it fills out what is it? What the hell is the fluid?
So is it sciatic fluid?
No, synovial fluid. It's the fluid between your joints. And, you know, I guess the theory is that Deca adds more to that. I've never really heard that confirmed, but either way, it helps.
So it can actually aid in repairing that joint cavity to a degree because it increases collagen synthesis, which is like, that's a really big benefit of Deca. Like the actual medical benefit of Deca is not just like the fluid, which is probably the number one reason why they prescribe it, but the actual collagen synthesis can actually create some long-term healing effects. I've known doctors to prescribe Deca and keep people on it year round, like no joke, for people that actually have like for medical uses. But when you're talking about medical uses of Deca, I don't know. Have you ever looked into like the actual medical use of Deca, like the dosages and stuff like that?
I haven't gone super deep into it. I remember reading that they use it for like burn victims sometimes. And like, cause I'm assuming for the collagen that it helps repair the skin or something like that. But I know like it's been used for like muscle wasting, you know, for like HIV cancer. I don't know about cancer, but yeah, jump right. Keep going if you want. I love that.
Yeah. So it's funny. So in studies, what people don't talk about is in the testosterone world, you have like normal levels, like 200 milligrams per week, 100 milligrams per week, or 200 milligrams per week. And then you have 300 milligrams per week. And then people are like, oh, you're super physiological now, which you absolutely are. But they go up to studies up to 600 milligrams per week. And this is in college students that they did these studies. And it was a very, very reputable study that the people do utilize the study time again for. But no one talks about 600 milligrams per milliliter. That's like an actual amount. I'm pretty sure that a doctor can prescribe. I know they can go up to 500. I'm not sure if they are allowed to go to 600. And as long as they're running labs and stuff like that. So the interesting thing is when you ever hear about like Deca is basically your general rule of thumb, you always have a 2-to-1 ratio, testosterone to Deca ratio. So you don't get erectile dysfunction. Now a doctor is not going to prescribe you 600 milligrams of testosterone and 300 milligrams of Deca. Like they could legally, I'm pretty sure, but it's like pushing the limitations and they wouldn't risk their license on something like that.
There'd have to be like a reason for that. Like there would have to be a reason.
Yeah, an actual medical reason for it. But what a doctor could do is they could have you on like 200 milligrams of testosterone. And guess what? The studies on Deca go up to therapeutic use of Deca goes up to 600 milligrams per week. Ooh. So yeah, it's something that a lot of people don't know about. I was doing research on like basically the actual medical uses for what the histories of it and stuff like that. And that's kind of the number that they ended up lining on. It's between 300 to 600 is real true therapeutic dose of Deca. Now, do they still use those dosages in the real world? I don't really think it's common unless if it's literally like a therapeutic use of something going on with your joints where they literally need to stop the atrophy or something like that. That's the only way I could think of it being prescribed at that dose, because if your test is low and your Deca is high, most people are going to have those issues. Some people don't. Some people are perfectly fine with high Deca and low test, but it's a very, very rare use case. And it's the bioindividuality and the pathwaying and how you break down the drugs in your body and stuff. But yeah, that's a long story. Is it goes up to 600 milligrams on both ends of the spectrum.